Tibetans have lived in exile for more than two decades. Religion still has a central place among the refugees, and today a traditional monastery housing 100 monks has been rebuilt near Simla in North India, situated above a refugee village of 400 Bunpos. The monastery is the guardian of the rich traditions of the religion, and it is both a place of teaching and a center for religious activities. This monastery belongs to a branch of the Tibetan religion called Burm, which claims to have its roots stretching back to times preceding the introduction of Buddhism to Tibet from India. According to the tradition, we find the source of the Burm religion in the Ulmulungring Lan in Central Asia. Ulmulungring is also a traditional symbol of the human subconsciousness. The Buddha Tonpa Shenrab brought the Burm religion to Tibet a long time ago. He introduced the Tibetans to the teaching of the transitory nature of the world. Through a long line of masters and wise men, the teaching was brought to the first abbots. The abbot Sangye Tenzin is the 33rd in the line of Burm's spiritual leaders. In this monastery, there are 60 monks and 40 novices under the personal care of Sangye Tenzin. The abbot's house is a separate institution in the monastery. The large temple with the temple courtyard is the center of the monastery. Both teaching and ceremonies take place here. The monk's accommodation is also situated near the temple courtyard. The deceased from the village below have their own little house in the monastery. Here, small moldings of clay and ash are placed. These monuments are memorials of former abbots. Situated just above the monastery is a small temple dedicated to the guardian deity of the monastery. When the signal for the morning activities are given, Sangye Tenzin is already reading religious texts. By the entrance to the assembly hall, the young novices are reading their texts. According to tradition, the training of the novices is based upon learning by heart. The morning reading is a preparation for the activities of the day, where the low chanting is a part of the meditation. To turn the prayer wheel is a century-old custom in Tibet. The prayers are printed on paper and put into the big barrel. The prayers are also printed on flags and cut onto rocks. Every morning, Sangye Tenzin reads a blessing for the novices. The older monks are eating by themselves, but the novices have organized themselves and they work in shifts with the preparation of their food. Most of the novices attend an ordinary Indian school in the village below. They are taught in Hindi. The debate training has started. Philosophical questions are hurled to the seated monk, who is required to give a quick and lucid answer, helped on by a clapping of hands when the point is good. This is also aimed at bringing the one being questioned out of balance. This is a very important part of the training in the monastery. The aim is to train and discipline the alertness and logic of the monks. A truly demanding exercise. The novices will profit from this exercise whether they choose to leave the monastery or become monks, a decision usually taken at the age of 20. Sangye Tenzing follows the exercise carefully. At the village weaver, an offering ceremony is taking place in honor of the guardian deity of the family. A young monk is assisting the older monks of the monastery, who performs all necessary rituals and ceremonies among the lay people of the village. Incense is used for purification. The drums The chanting, the offering cakes and the rice beer provides a frame around a sacred space of time where the people are in contact with the guardian deity. The Bonpo sees no marked distinction between ritual life and daily life. The meal ends the ritual. Prayer before the noon meal. Most of the monks eat their last meal at noon. Reading during the meal is a Catholic monastic practice brought by Sangye Tenzin. The leaders of the Burn religion are outstanding for their openness and interest in other religions and traditions. 35 of the monks are committed to an intensive study of the teaching of Burn. Through 8 years of higher education, the monks will get a thorough knowledge of Tibetan philosophy, language, poetry, astrology, and ceremonial practices. All teaching is a basis for meditation. Sangye Tenzin is also directing all practical activities in the monastery. The children are preparing tomorrow's breakfast for the rest of the novices. The dough is cut into noodle shape and cooked with the vegetables to a tasty soup. In the small temple room above the assembly hall, monks are evoking the deities. The monks have already prepared cakes of flour and butter as ritual offerings. When the offering has taken place, the cakes are given to the animals. Through the monastic initiation, the monks learn to know other aspects of the rituals. They say that the strong fragrance of incense is a help to reach an open and undisturbed inner state of being, a preparation for the evocation of the powerful energies of the subconsciousness. According to the monks, these forces are the lusts and illusions of man, symbolized by wrathful deities. With the help of the ritual and the meditation, these energies can be transformed to what they call a piercing consciousness of reality. Every 10th day is a day off. Excerpts from the lion dance was shown for the filming. Usually it is only performed at the Tibetan New Year festival in February. The celebration on New Year is an occasion for pilgrimage to the monastery for all Bunpos. The pocket money of the novices was invested in firecrackers this time. Fragrant fire is ancient tradition when a venerable lama is expected. Sangye Tenzing prepares the children for the reception ceremony. Lay people of the village are present to greet the High Lama. This ceremony gives the lay people an opportunity to show their respect for the spiritual leaders of the monastery. All the monks come together to perform rituals once given by the Buddha Champa Shenrab to his disciples.